inside Pauley Pavilion, the first of two today, as the round of 64 continues here in Southern California. And this is Desiree Young, who gets a post touch on the first possession.
But she will look to get her shots as well.
Couldn't hit the close range look there. And there's a blow by Molly Mogensen with the right hand scoop. Mogensen, number 21 in the white, finds Ronsick. That one was blocked from behind, and Mallory Brake cleans it up. UNLV on a 15-game win streak. Kim, they trampled the Mountain West Conference again, went 17-1. Young on a turnaround, got it to go. Jackson now in a hurry, finds Young. Ball fake, gets into the paint, finds Brown. Jensen, very prolific scorer, so keep an eye on 15 in white today. One of the premier scorers in the Big East, cashes in from deep. One of the first late shot clock looks. Both teams can certainly get up and down the floor quick, and Jackson scores. Young back out to Jackson. Young turns, puts it up, and banks it in.
We talked about UNLV's leading scorer, Desiree Young, closing in on 2,000 points. She is yet.
Find themselves down one in the first quarter of this 7-10 battle. Jackson.
Yeah, it looks like the officials are saying it's going to count, and Kiara Jackson is just such a shifty guard. Yeah. That was called on Desiree Young, but the basket was before the foul, so it'll count.
So that's the first foul on Young. Creighton attacks once again. Great, the offensive board, and the putback is there.
Creighton hasn't opened up overly hot from the floor, but they've gotten a couple of offensive rebounds for some second chance points.
Jamie Horan knocks down the three. 20 on the shot clock.
And here's Jamie Horan, fresh off too much space on the contest. There was a game towards the end of the Big East regular season where she went, I think it was 5 for 5 from three.
UNLV scores close to 80 a game. Creighton will score close to 75. Look who's wide open. That three is down. Jensen with her second. They have been very effective from beyond the three-point line this year. Jackson now on the attack, spins, that's good. Break is now open, turns down the three, Horan, another!
Creighton doing...
Well, we've had a couple of impressive comebacks. Iowa State the other yesterday.
Audie Crooks, big time performance for the freshman, 40 yeah. points.
40 piece. Jensen maybe tracking in that direction. She's got 9. 16-6 run. Blue Jays by 7.
These Blue Jays, they can let it fly. Lauren Jensen, 3 of 3.
A corner in which Creighton has hit 5 threes. This is the freshman Kimson. Splits a pair into the paint. That one's blocked. Knocked out of bounds. 2.7 to go. Jackson trying to create a crossover. 1 second. Did she get it off in time? Bounces out anyway. Young, the offensive board, and the stick back. What's most critical here to the way Creighton works offensively?
Well, I think just how they move the...
Oh, wow, another triple.
Take a look at the foul call that I believe Creighton will get the ball back. Here's Jensen running along the baseline.
And UNLV needs a bit of an answer now early in the second.
Yeah, they got to get moving the ball a little bit more. They've been a bit stagnant. That time they find Desiree Young a little bit more space. They have to allow her to operate with some room, not allow Creighton to collapse on her.
She's into double figures. That's a sweet move by Jensen. And Jackson now on the move. Maybe some numbers. Scoggin puts it up and buries the three. That's a big one. We'll see if that translates today. Jensen on the blow by, lays it up and in.
Lauren Jensen, they're respecting her at the three-point line, but she blows by and can attack.
Scoggin was looking for back-to-back, but instead rebound down to Molly. That's Creighton's rebound leader. She's open, the lefty knocks down another. They are red hot from beyond the arc.
Creighton doing a nice job of getting back in transition defense. You see them stopping that drive right away, but Jackson finds another way.
Florida Gulf Coast, the 12 seed, almost became the second to move on earlier today. Oklahoma just held them off at the end. In Westwood, Creighton can't miss from deep. She doesn't take too many, but she's pretty efficient on the year.
She's tripled her scoring average. She's still in the first half.
Goodness. Young, boy, that shot off the glass is muddy, isn't it? There's a turnover. Good perimeter defense by Jackson and Durazo Frescas. Jackson into the paint. Had it knocked away from behind. Obeizer spins once again. Oh, the lefty scoop. That was pretty. They're feeling it right now on a 7-0 run. Molly from deep knocks it down. Great answer. Another 15-point-per-game scorer, one of three in the lineup. Obeizer, that's way short. Here comes Jensen. Inside of a minute now in the first half. Molly, oh, it's a heat check. Puts in another.
Big East semifinal loss to Georgetown. They shot 19% from three in that game. They've certainly found their shot again.
Well, it was a strange way that that one came to a close. Here's a steal and a score.
But to put up 10, and a lot of them were just uncontested, missed assignments, so interested to see their response on the defensive end.
Young ball fake, got Ronsick in the air.
A monster scorer, Desiree Young. Congrats on 2,000.
2,000 in 4 years. She is a four-year senior, not a fifth-year senior. Jensen picking up right where she left off, now with 16. You know, this number has been insurmountable for a lot of Creighton's opponents. That's Young's turn. Jensen working off the screen. Hits Blake, one dribble. Caught underneath. Ronsick looking for her first make of the day, and she buries the three. So that was in the WNIT championship game in which Creighton won. There's Ronsick. The fadeaway, that's a difficult look. So she hits her first two shots after the break, after a scoreless first half. And Ronsick with the takeaway. Creighton now in early in this third quarter. It's Creighton by 16. Young going back to work. Plunge it into Molly. Got it to go.
Yeah, it totally is. And I think you see it pay off in a situation like this, and not that you can't win, as Emma Ronsick has really caught fire here in the second half, year to year, but they've had incredible success. I've talked to Jim Flannery over the course of the season. He said, we found different ways to win with the maturity. Alyssa Brown.
There was some major disappointment when this team went home in the round of 64 a year ago. They lost as a 6 seed, the 11th seed of Mississippi State. Squad. Jackson now with a triple.
In the three-point line, they have to try to stop those three attempts and get going a little bit on their own. They're a team that usually makes about 8 threes per game.
Ronsick scores it right at the rim.
Emma Ronsick, a center.
And wants to march on to the round of 32. The winner would face either UCLA or California Baptist.
Yeah, talk about unstoppable. Pretty much any time she's had a touch, she's getting it in for two.
Oh, Ronsick has come alive in the second half.
Talk about the big three. Emma Ronsick was scoreless at the half. She's up to 12 points here in the second.
First time she's
inside. You see her getting a good post up, good position on that one. Anyone else on this Creighton roster, she can hurt you from three as well. Emma Ronsick, 12 points in the second half.
Well, she can't be denied this time again. Now 14. Well, making it was like a true hockey sub, right? Five on, five off. Jackson from the free throw line. Ronsick has got the smaller freshman on her. Goes up and scores it. Kimson now, the rookie of the year of the conference, bounces it to Young. She's just automatic underneath. Young in the paint, kicks it out to Kimson, 4-3. Right where she left off in the third quarter, she went 7 of 10 and now has another triple. Alyssa Brown answers, And UNLV needs it.
See it on the men's side, and I think it's been lacking. So thank you to Lisa Mattingly for joining our tournament crew.
And Women's Basketball Hall of Famer Ronsick, boy, she just... Ronsick finds a wide open Morgan Molly, got it. And Creighton's lead balloons back to 16.
To best attack it, and that's what they do.
Creighton has led by double digits for the entirety of this second half. LaRocque calls the timeout. Very candid with us. Players that come to play for her at UNLV, you better be winners and you better want to be coached. Young playing with the four fouls, but it was very brief and early in the first. Molly, oh, that's an impressive one-legged fadeaway from Morgan Molly. She was red hot to close out the regular season and was terrific in their two Big East tournament games. She's got 16 today. Boy, Young is a wizard in the paint. She's 13.
Rebels 48%, but Creighton, you're right, they've just stayed steady, and that's where this veteran presence has certainly come into play.
Kimson got that one to go, so back to an 11-point game.
So again, we mentioned it earlier, multiple stops in a row have to occur.
Late shot clock offense for the Blue Jays. Baseline jumper, break, hits it.
Break is the least dangerous offensive threat on the floor, but she confidently takes her opening.
Desi Ray Young got it to go, and the foul.
Not say enough about the offensive game that Desi Ray Young is having. It's been automatic, her post-up.
Jensen with five to shoot. Jensen, the crossover, the runner. Oh, how did that one go?
Had that basketball on a string, just toying with the defender through the legs, hesitation.
The Hyrie doing it late in the shot clock as well. So if you're UNLV, you're running out of time. Jensen knocks down a triple. And so Creighton has rebuilt a 16-point lead. An incredibly efficient shooting day by this Blue Jays team. They're well past their season average of 73 a game. Young.
Really same thing on the Creighton side. None of those seniors have announced their plans. They could all come back as well.
There's the first basket of the night for Durazo Frescas. Gibson pulls up from six. That's McKenna Brackens. It's a new 20 for the Lady Rebels. That one's good for Durazo Frescas.
Them in South Carolina, the only two teams with back-to-back 30-win seasons, so still lots to come for UNLV.
But Creighton is